Around the World with MS World. I'm Dr. Daniel Cantor here with MS World at the Consortium of MS Centers annual meeting. One of the great things about the CMSC meeting is that we get to discuss a lot of aspects of MS, and we get to discuss a lot of it with non-neurologists. So I'm so happy to be joined here by Dr. Ascherio, who is Professor of Epidemiology and Nutrition at the Harvard School of Public Health. One of the things that you lecture about today was vitamin D, and this is a major topic that a lot of people want to know about. What do we know about vitamin D in multiple sclerosis?
Well, we know that individuals with low level of vitamin D have a higher risk of developing MS. And among individuals who have MS, those with low vitamin D level tend to do much worse in terms of disease activity and long-term prognosis.
Now, sometimes people say, well, if I have low vitamin D, do I need to check it? Maybe everyone with MS has low vitamin D. What have you guys found? Have you found that everyone has low vitamin D, or does it look like we should be testing people?
Well, about half of the individual with MS have low vitamin D level. So I think either you take supplements or you measure your level and then you decide whether to take supplements or not.
And is there controversy about this idea about mega doses? You know, a lot of people talk about the recommended daily allowance of vitamin D is probably too low. So a lot of people supplement 1,000, 2,000 international units, maybe 4,000 international units. But what about these mega doses? Is this something that we have agreement on?
No, I think there is absolutely no evidence that mega doses are beneficial in individual with MS or any other disease. I think the evidence is that high normal level, and we're talking about for the U.S. audience up to 40 nanogram per ml, which is 100 nanomole per liter. And this level can be achieved with supplement certainly below 4,000 IU per day in the majority of people.
So you've heard it right here at MS World. For most people, 4,000 international units a day of vitamin D3 is a good idea and should be enough. Of course, if you want to take higher doses, that's something that you should do upon recommendation with your doctor. So if you have any other questions about vitamin D, please talk to your primary care physician and talk to your neurologist. Thank you for joining us.